This problem is related to electronic transition in a hydrogen atom. Let us read this problem and try yourself. So we have to find longest wavelength for the following transition. And transition we have, that is n is equals to 2 to n is equals to 1, and then we have n is equals to 3 to n is equals to 2, and then we also have n is equals to 4 to n is equals to 3. So these are the transitions, and we have to calculate longest wavelength, that is lambda max. Now let us say, if you remember, energy in a hydrogen like atom is given by formula minus 13.6 divided by n square into z square, and this energy in electron volt. Now if I have a hydrogen atom, in this case z is equals to 1, so we can modify this formula. This becomes minus 13.6 divided by n square electron volt. We can calculate corresponding energy. Let us say for E1 we will have energy minus 13.6, and n is 1, so this is a square, so we will have minus 13.6 EV. Now let us calculate energy in level 2, and that is minus 13.6 divided by 2 square, so this is minus 13.6 divided by 4. Now if we use calculator, so we have 13.6 divided by 4, so this is 3.4, so this energy is minus 3.4 electron volt. We can similarly calculate energy in third orbital, that is E3, minus 13.6 divided by 3 square, that is 9, so we will have 13.6 divided by 9, and this is around minus 1.51 electron volt. Now we will have E4, that is minus 13.6 divided by 4 square, so we will have this divided by 16. So this is around minus 0.85 electron volt. Now if we plot energy, so basically we have E1 is equals to minus 13.6 EV, E2 is equals to minus 3.4 EV, and we have E3, that is minus 1.51 EV, and E4, that is minus 0.85 EV. So let us plot these energy on a line diagram, that is n versus energy. So here we have n, that is this is n is equals to 1, this is n is equals to 2, this is n is equals to 3, and similarly this is n is equals to 4. And the first energy is minus 13.6, and this side we are writing energy in electron volt, and the second is minus 3.4, and third one is minus 1.51. So you see the difference is getting a smaller and a smaller, and finally we have minus 0.85. We have to find longest wavelength. So we have to find longest wavelength. So if you remember, E is equals to hc by lambda. This means lambda is equals to, or we can write delta E is equals to hc by lambda. So lambda is equals to hc by E. So this means if I want lambda maximum, my energy difference should be minimum. And this is possible, delta E in that case, it should be minimum. Now let us see the transition. The first transition we have, that is 2 to 1, that is this transition. Then we have transition from 3 to 2. That is this transition. And then we have further transition, that is 4 to 3. That is this transition. You see which has the lowest energy. So you can clearly see this difference is the lowest one. Basically we can calculate all these differences. So what is the difference here? That is 13.6 minus 3.4. This is 10.2. So this difference is basically 10.2 EV. So difference between level 2 and 1 and level 3 and 2, that is 3.4 minus 1.51. This is 1.89, so this difference is 1.89, and the last difference is 1.51 minus 0.85, and this is 0.66, so we have 0.66. So difference in energy level is minimum for 4 to 3. So difference is, so delta E minimum we have for transition four to three. So we will have corresponding lambda maximum for transition four to three. So basically four to three transition will have maximum wavelength. That is this one, 4 to 3 will have maximum wavelength.